I'm Roshni, and this is Beta Grew Up. Hi everyone, so this is part two of the Feeling Undeserving video. This is going to be a little bit more on the positive side. The first part of the video, if you haven't seen it yet, kind of unpacks feeling undeserving of your goals or the belief that you're not worthy enough. And so if you want more information on that, I will link it in the description. And this video, like I said, is more about four ways that you can actually practically start doing today, feeling like you do deserve your goals, like you are worthy of the success that you want to achieve one day, whatever that might look like to you. My first tip is basically to find a way that you can take affirmations seriously. So find a way to connect with each one of your affirmations every single day that will resonate with you. It could be making a music video. It could be recording what your affirmations are and playing them back to yourself every single morning as you're getting ready. So I used to be really into writing slam poetry, and sometimes the words that you write just kind of get stuck in your head. If anyone out there knows what I'm talking about, give me a thumbs up, leave a comment below, because yeah, the way that they can kind of just ring in your head when you're not even thinking about it, that's what affirmations should be for you. And that constant reminder that you are enough, you are worthy, you know, you should believe in yourself, you deserve to live your dream life, to achieve whatever your idea of success is. You deserve all of these things. And so to remind yourself of that every single day will really help you change that automatic subconscious process into being a much more positive one instead of one that could self-sabotage you. My second tip is to find your voice. So what I mean by this is to find some sort of creative outlet, whether it be starting a blog that's mostly just for you, creating art that's just for yourself, or it could be something much more external, like creating different fashion looks for yourself, or makeup looks, or whatever it might be. And you can, you know, wear these in public or post them online, but make it something that's not necessarily dependent on that external validation. If whatever you want to do to remind yourself of your own unique perspective and your own creative voice is really important. And the reason why I say that you don't necessarily have to share these is creativity doesn't necessarily have to solve anything. Creativity doesn't have to, you know, be your next moneymaker. It can just be something that you do for you. And creating for yourself is honestly the best way to remind yourself that you do have a voice, that you do have something unique that you're bringing to the table. My third tip is to add your own pictures to your vision board. As you can see, I've done back here. I love getting pictures developed. I always have a disposable camera with me. And the reason I do that is because sometimes, you know, you find like these Pinterest-worthy or Instagram-worthy images that are perfect, and that's what you put on your vision board, and that's great. You know, we're all stretching for these ideal images, these ideal goals, but at the same time, your life isn't always going to look Pinterest-worthy, and you could be achieving the very goals that you want, but it looks nothing like those images that you have on your vision board. So if you have pictures of your ideal goals alongside with you taking steps to achieve those goals, you'll be able to recognize and congratulate yourself when you actually are taking actionable steps towards those goals. And sometimes, you know, it may not look super glamorous to be starting your own blog. Every day that you wake up and do that, you might not look like the fashion blogs that you see online, but remind yourself that maybe you are sitting on the couch in sweatpants editing your writing and posting it, and it's not very glamorous, but you're still working towards your goals. You'll stop putting so much pressure on yourself and keep saying to yourself that you're not doing it, and instead realize what doing it looks like for you. My fourth and final tip is to demonstrate the control in your life. And this is probably the most fun tip so far. And what I mean by that is basically doing something like dyeing your hair. Something even smaller, like just making your Tuesday night a self-care night, or doing self-care practices, things that you love every single day for a week. A lot of the times with school going on in our careers and debt or finances or whatever these things are, it can feel so all-consuming and make you feel like you have absolutely no control in your own life. But the truth is, we have the power to make massive life-changing decisions every single day, and we just need to believe that and know that and really live it. So if you feel like, you know, you're at the whelm of, you know, all your homework and all your debt and all your family obligations, take that time to really just take an hour or two and prove to yourself that no, you are in control. Making small changes and proving your control in small ways can a lot of the time, you know, catapult into much bigger ways of you getting your life together and feeling like you do control your life. So thank you so much for watching this video. I really hope it helped. If you Have a favorite tip, or if you have anything else to add, please let me know down below in the comments. Give me a thumbs up. I hope to see you again in my next video.